All right, hello once again. This is Jeff Scott, your instructor for the online version of 152, 157, website development, XHTML, CSS for the fall 2015 semester at Black Hawk Technical College. We're starting chapter 4 now, and as you can see, it's entitled Visual Elements and Graphics. All right, so we're going to come in here and we're going to do four of the prime properties. We're going to do some work as far as actually adding some images. The images are all available to you. We'll talk about color in here and a few other things. All right, the first thing that we're asked to do, and what I have done, this is kind of an FYI for you, but what I have done is I went in and I copied my all the contents. First of all, I fixed this. Chapter 1 had no exercises. Chapter 2 had just these two. Chapter 3, we were doing some more work, but I took the Index 4 and the Styles, which was our most up-to-date version of the Trillium site, and I copied that over to Chapter 4. So now I'm going to open that up, because it says on here that right before we've got the footer, we should be putting in a horizontal rule tag. This is another one of those tags that does not repeat. It does not have an ending tag. So I'll tell you what. Let's not put it in, and then let's run this under Chrome. All right, you can see, I guess we do have our colors now. All right, so whatever we were doing wrong before has been fixed. Boy, that's god-awful, but that's all right. All right, we'll just leave it the way that it is. Now we're going to come back in, and we're going to add that HR tag. And before we go and run this again, please look right here, all right, right there, right up above the copyright line. You'll notice there's nothing there, and now there is. That's what the HR tag did. It was a horizontal rule tag. All right, now that I'm looking at this too. According to that, I do have it on the desktop, so I'll make sure I move that stuff over too. All right, so we put in the horizontal rule tag. They talk about some dashed and some properties. There's a really good chart that's in your book. All right, a really good chart in your book. And I'm going to go back. It's on page 136. One thing I don't like about what the author has done here is I don't like her usage of color. It actually appears much better on screen here, I think, than it does in the book. In the book, it looks too washed out. But on 136 and on 137 and on the top of page 138, they talk about a lot of these margin and padding properties. All right, so I'm going to come in and just follow what the author is talking about. So this hands-on practice, hands-on practice here that's on page 138. All right, so they want us to add some padding here, 15 pixels of padding for our H1. And in order to do that, I'm going to have to bring up from the styles folder the index 4. Okay? And H1, there's no padding in there right now, as you can see. So we've added it. Let's see what that did for our H1. There's our H1 tag right here. Now with padding. Interesting. Don't want to launch that. All right, we've added some more padding around it. You may or may not be able to tell. Okay, so that was the first thing. Secondly, we're supposed to add a style rule to our H2 element, as it says there, to configure a 2-pixel dashed bottom border in the color pound 191970. So let's do that. That looks okay pretty much the way that it is here. again, that was for our H2. The order in which you put these lines here does not matter. The background color could have been last, etc. It's not any problem at all. All right, here's our H2 here and here. So let's refresh, and there's our dashed lines. Again, you may have your own feelings as far as, wow, Jeff, you did that, you made it look even uglier. And I'm not going to disagree with that at all, but I believe what the author is trying to show in here is she's trying to put together kind of a culmination of everything that she's been talking about throughout the chapter. All right, so I'm just following her lead. Add styles to the footer element to configure a thin, solid top border in a certain color along with 10 pixels of top padding. Also configure the footer to have gray text. So here's the new stuff that we're putting in here. Copy. So this is for the footer. And again, the author says save it as this, save it as that, and I may or may not be doing it that way. That's not what's important. The important thing is that I'm putting the information in here that we were asked to put in. All right, so there's our border top, thin, solid in that color, padding top, 10 pixels, and we're changing the color. I guess that color was already there, so I'll remove, and I'll keep the bottom one, just remove the top one. All right, so again, now we want to look down here at our footer and refresh. Okay, move down a little and the color has changed. All right, so that's everything in the practice two that's on page 138. Then the author started to talk quite a bit about different types of graphics. And our next example here isn't until page 145. And I'm going to turn there in the book in just a second. So all the stuff that was in here previous to this, okay, all the stuff previous was talking about up till this page, it was talking about different, you know, all the different types of images that you can have, the pings and the GIFs and the, you know, etc., JPEGs. All right, so launch an editor, open starter 2. Yeah, this is something new. So replace the content in the H1 code and element with a banner. Remember to include the source. Boom, 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 boom. So we want to put in all this stuff. How's that? So we want to replace the text that in the, our H1 tag with this stuff. Not a problem. Here's our H1 tag, where is it? There it is. So we want to replace all that, and we want to replace it with this, okay? Now, I'm going to have to go and add that image, so I'm going to have to go grab that. And I have no problem at all doing that, but like I said, it'll take a second to grab that particular image, all right? And it says image source equals, well, what I'm going to do too is I'm going to say images slash that, because I'm going to make an images folder. So I want to find the Trillium banner. Okay. Now, how am I going to do this? There's the student data assignments right there. Let's see what's data files rather. So let's see what's in there for chapter 4. Which is what we're in. I'm looking for that Trillium. I'm looking for that particular image. This is hands-on practice 4-3. There's the banner. So I want to copy that. And I want to put that into a new folder called images and then paste it in. Okay, so that's the banner right there. All right, now this is going to look really god-awful because I haven't changed my color settings to the way the author has their color settings. All right, so we're mixing purples and greens, which kind of looks god-awful, but it'll be fine. All right, so that's practice three. And we want to make sure that the image border style is set to none in our CSS. So let's go in and do that. Since our image is right after that H1 tag, I'm going to put that right here. So border style none. Okay, that may not have changed the look of this at all. Looks like it has not. That's fine. All right, our next hands-on practice. Now we want to do for in here, we want to go and we're going to want to add yet another picture. All right. Now again, as we go through here, I may or may not be adding every single thing that the author shows. All right. Now first, what I'd like to do, because this color is just starting to drive me nuts here, is I'm going to come in here and I'm going to close this index4.css, okay? And from the student data files, let me extract this. From chapter 4, this is practice 4.4. Looking in here for the CSS file. That's 4.3. Let's look at what the author has here. This is the author's 4.3. All right, so you can see how it's changing. These have changed here, and our color scheme has totally changed. Most of the rest of the stuff that's in there, I have in mind. So that's the author's. And that's mine here. So again, I want to go in and change so that I'm using the author's stuff, so to speak. So the author has taken everything and put it inline. Okay, I don't like that, so I'm not going to use it. I'm going to grab all of her stuff that she's got here, and I'm going to replace my index 4 with her stuff. All right, now, you'll bear with me a second because I'm a little anal about this stuff. I want this to at least somewhat line up. Again, it's just much easier for me to work with it that way. Almost finished here. Again, this is my style of setting this stuff up. Some people like to put their curly brace on the same line. That, you know, they could maybe do this where I've done it in like four lines here. They would have done it in one or two. You have to come up with your own style. And as long as you come up with a style and you're consistent with it, I don't really care what style you use. But I've said this to students before that, in my opinion, even a bad style, one that I wouldn't necessarily use, or one that maybe necessarily wouldn't look the best is better than no style at all. Just about finished. So again, this is the authors, and I'm just doing this because to key this in would just be an exercise in futility. All right, so let's save that. Now go back to our page, and let's refresh, and it's looking a lot more like the authors did. All right? There's still maybe a few things that are out of whack, so to speak, but that's okay. It really is. All right. Now I'm jumping up to hands-on practice 4-5, which is on page 149 in the text. And that was the author's, and this is mine. Okay. All right. So they want us to put in some more stuff into our CSS file. So since this is our image, and we're going to put some fig caption stuff in here. All right. So we're going to put some figure stuff in here and some fig caption stuff in here. Now, I've said this to you before. This is my personal take on this. All right, there's the body. That body there's the footer. I like the footer to be at the bottom, so that's where I'm going to put it. All right, there's my body stuff here. Header, that's fine. H1, H2, P, UL, nav, that looks okay. All right, image, figure, caption. I'll just leave it the way it is, but put that at the bottom. All right, so I want the width here to be 640 pixels. I want there to be a border around it. It'll be a 1 pixel solid border. And since it's pound 000000, it means it'll be black. I want 5 pixels of padding all the way around it. Remember, that's our shortcut, which says 5 at the top, 5 at the right, 5 at the bottom, 5 at the left. And for our fig caption, we want the text align to be centered, and we want the font family be papyrus, and if you don't have that, fantasy. We're supposed to modify the title element and add an image to the body section to display this. Okay, so I'll have to put that image in here. So we'll put that in the beginning of our body section. And I'm going to put in here our image tag. Our source is going to be equal to, and I'll have to pull that in, myisland.jpg. We'll have some alternative text here. And it has a height and a width of, or a height of 480. Doesn't matter if you put the height first or the width first. It really and truly does not matter. The width is 640. So I've got to grab that My Island JPEG file. If I do it right now, it's not going to look any different. All right, it's got the area for it there, but it's not going to look any different. And it's not looking any different because it hasn't found the file. So let's go grab the file. I'm looking for the tropical island in here. of course, I don't see. And it says it does not have it in there. Search chapter 4. And it says it's not there. Well, let's check the whole thing. So, in other words, let's check everything that we've got here. And it says there's nothing in there that matches our search. Wow. Says the photo used is located in the Student Files Chapter 4 Starters folder. Copy. Paste. All right, let's come back and let's refresh. Still not showing it to us. Did I save? I did save. Source is equal to images slash, because I have an images folder. And there it is. All right, I'll tell you what, we don't have right now, we don't have a services page. We don't have a contact page. Okay? So, rather than having this up here, and there's nothing wrong with it being up there, what I'm going to do very quickly is a little bit different than the author did it, but I'm going to do this. I'm going to take this whole page here, and I'm going to copy it to a new page. I'm going to save that new page as island.html. Okay? Then I'm going to go back to my index page here where I have all my stuff. And this will be island. Okay? So I've got all that stuff in there now. Let's go back to the top of this page and where we put that image in. Let's remove it. It's in the other page already, so that's fine. Let's go to Island here. And there's our image. We'll have a div, but we'll have nothing in it. Well, we'll put all this stuff in it right there. How's that? So let's take a look at what we just did. There's Island, and there's the picture. That's good, but I wanted to remove that from here. It shouldn't be there anymore. All right, and I've got to move Island over a little bit too. So there's our design. There's home. Don't worry about that. Services, contact, and island. Okay? As far as I can tell, at least, it looks okay now. It says that it can't. Oh, our index 4, we've got to change the name of this to index. That's going to cause some problems here because I've got it called index 4 instead of index. Now it should be okay. Okay. All right. So I've done pretty much everything that's in the one for 9.94, and in 9.5, we put that information in there, and then we're supposed to come in. Now, if you look right now under Island, we don't have any figure. All right, so I think we're supposed to add that. So underneath the actual image itself right here, well, we've got the figure tag, so let's put this whole thing in a figure tag. All right, there's our image. Okay, so that's all that stuff. And then we want a fig caption in there. And we want to end our figure tag. All right, so as far as our caption goes, just tropical. Island getaway. And there it is. There should have been some CSS for that, so let's see if we had the CSS and we put that in there. Fake caption, text align center. Font family, papyrus, and fantasy. So it's not showing up in here. Oh, yeah, we've got it. Styles, index4.css. Border padding. Well, hopefully that'll clear itself up as we get going in here, because I don't see any problem with it. All right. The next thing that's in here that we're actually supposed to put in is up on page 154. All right, I'm going to do that one next here. So that's practice 4.6. Like I said, that bothers me a bit, but maybe it's because we didn't save. Let's see if that's the case. There it is. Got a border around it. It's got the different text, etc. Okay. All right. So practice 9.6. Modify the style for the H2 element to include to configure the background image and a background repeat properties. Okay, so we'll put that in. So we've got to come back into here, into our H2 tag. All right, and that's all of it, so. Those blank spaces after the colon are not necessary, but I like putting them in. So we want, we'll put images here, and we want trilliumbullet.gif. We've got to find that next. Copy. Paste that in. Let's make sure everything we were working on has been saved. That's saved. That's saved. Okay. We're supposed to have a little image right here. In here, and we do not. All right, I want to see how long this lesson is getting to be, so just give me a second here. All right, we're okay. Do have H2 tags. Background image URL images trilliumbullet.gif. Background repeat, no repeat. That little image is supposed to be showing here and here, and as of right now, it's not. I'm going to pause the video for a minute and see if I can fix it, then I'll come back and tell you what I did to try to fix it. All right, well, I tried every fix I could think of. I moved it over 30 pixels, like they said, but for some reason, it's still not showing right here. And if I get time, I'll try to take a look at it later and see if I can figure out what the problem is. But as of right now, I don't know what that problem is. All right, they talk about some image maps in the book next and some favicons. I'm not going to go through any of that stuff. I'll let you do that if you have an interest in doing so. And in hands-on practice 4.8, they add a couple more things. So let's try adding those and see if that works. So we've got our body section at the top, our background color, our font family, our color, and our minimum width. And we're supposed to come in here and add a background image. URL Trillium gradient dot ping, and then a background. So I've got to bring in the Trillium gradient and the Trillium foot. Now I've tried taking both of these, all of these, and putting them both in an images folder and in a non-images folder, but it didn't seem as though that mattered. But I am going to put them in there because that's the best practice to do that. So I'm going to bring that back to right, so I need to bring in Trillium Foot and Trillium Gradient. There's Trillium Foot, and there's Trillium Gradient. Now, with the luck that I've been having, this isn't going to look any different. All right. It is. I guess it does look a little bit different. The color is different and the like. All right. And I'm not sure if we're supposed to get that or not. But I'm not getting my pictures over here, and I don't know why. I'll go back, like I said, if I get time and try to figure out why that is the case. But as of right now, I don't know what the problem is. Now, the rest of the hands-on practices don't deal with this particular with the Trillium, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to save mine, okay? So I've got all my stuff right here, and I'm going to put another folder in here, and I'm going to call that Authors version, all right? And then I'm going to come in here, and I'm going to drag in from the student data files all of the Chapter 4 stuff. Put that in. Now once we do that, and we go through, I think the last one in here is like 4.8, and once you go through the index, that's what we were supposed to get there, and then over here, we're supposed to add these things, etc. Right, so I'm not sure exactly what the problem is with mine, but it's quite obvious that there is a problem. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the author's version when I copy this stuff over for Chapter 5 in just a minute. What we'll do next is we'll talk about the homework, which starts on page 194 in the book, and that'll be the next topic of the next lecture.